Good morning, guys! I actually woke up a little bit earlier this morning, although right now I think it's already like 10:30. I did go to Starbucks and I got the same dragon drink, and actually they made it with coconut milk this time. And that sandwich, oh my gosh, it's so good. This camera is a workout. I've been doing this now for a week and a half and my arms have not gotten stronger by doing this. Feeling the burn, feeling the burn. This is you guys. I have to put it out full arms length. This is hard to illustrate, but full arms length and then up. My arms are very short, so I don't have the luxury of relaxing my arms. It's just like fully out there. And oof. Today, we actually have some stuff that we need to do outside of the apartment, which I'm very excited about. I need to pick up a couple of things for a video that I'm doing. And then also there's a Trader Joe's like right near there, so I figured I would go there as well. I don't shop there for my regular groceries just because it's a real hassle because it's far away to walk all the way there, which is actually not the hard part. The hard part is once you get your stuff to walk all the way back. So I can't get an entire grocery trip, that's for sure. So we're just gonna pick up a couple of things. I really love some of the stuff at Trader Joe's you cannot get anywhere else, so I want to see if I can find them. The only thing I think is just the cauliflower gnocchi. Oh my gosh, it's so good. And that's like the only thing that I think I need from there. I know there are so many when I watch other people's like Trader Joe's hauls, I always get ideas for what I want to buy and then I forget it. And I also can't buy anything frozen. I just recently saw someone got like chocolate covered bananas, which looked kind of good. Although I feel like you can make them not frozen really easily, but if I buy anything frozen, it'll be melted by the time I get back. I heard Trader Joe's is really good with like social distancing and all that stuff. Although I think I told you guys this in the beginning, someone in the neighbors app that I follow, they were like Trader Joe's has all these lines and arrows and you can't like deviate from the arrows. And I'm just like, I'm not going to Trader Joe's. Like, that freaks me out. That is so many rules. So we're gonna see if that is how it is. Because if that is how it is, I guarantee you I'm gonna mess up and they're gonna yell at me. I feel like it's a little bit more relaxed now, so I think they'll let me like walk down an aisle the way I want to, but who knows. That's what we have to do today, and then I'll come back and I'll show you guys what I got. Again, not trying to get too much because these arms, they're weak right now. Really nice to get outside. I'm gonna try and like, you know, do it slowly. When I have to walk a long distance, I tend to like move my little legs really fast because I just hate the longness of it, but gonna try and relax. Also, like, PS, this morning, this is so annoying that I'm like this, but this thing, remember this guy from my tour? The light bulb went out in it, and I need that light. That's the only thing that gives me warmth. The ring light and soft boxes are very white, and I like to have a little bit of warmth in my face. Well, that went out. I have never seen something so difficult to buy as light bulbs. There are a million. There, if you want to look like you're in Cancun, if you want to look like you're in Cancun, but it's a little cloudy out, like there are just so many lights. I tried to look at what was on the light bulb. Well, they don't even sell that light bulb anymore. I hate change. I think I've told you guys this a million times. I hate change. Well, I got the new light bulbs that I had chosen. I chose soft white. I put it in here and I swear it's not the same light. Does it look different to you? It just seems so bright. I guess it definitely is warm, but I don't know if it's just me or if it's the light. Literally the tiniest problem in the freaking world, but yeah, light bulbs suck. I hate light bulbs. Also this morning, I found the ugliest, I don't wanna say biggest, because biggest is relative, but it was very, very big. It's bigger than most little bugs you find around the apartment. It was so gross, I can't even explain. I don't wanna go into details. But it was too gross to kill because it was too big. I let it go thinking that later I could have a little bit of help to kill it, but now I can't find it. So now I'm afraid of my bathroom. I swear, if that thing crawls on me, like just throw me away. Like there's no saving me. Like, I like need to see it again, and I kinda look for it every time I go in the bathroom, but when I do see it, it's gonna make my heart just... But I need to find it. All right, I'm just finishing up my list and let's go. All right, I thought I could do it, but now I'm just overexcited about Trader Joe's because I never go, so. I'm just online just looking up people's like top picks for Trader Joe's to see if I should get like a couple other things that people recommend. I also just put on Instagram asking you guys what you think I should get, so hopefully I can get a couple of the things that you guys recommend. But I'm just looking, and so I haven't left yet. I'm still here. We will go. I'm trying to find cool angles. I don't know if this is a cool angle or not, but here we are. I was gonna show you what I got from Trader Joe's, and maybe. Didn't think about, I had asked you guys what I should get from Trader Joe's, and there was no reception in Trader Joe's. So I couldn't even look at what you guys said, but whatever you guys said, I'll use on my next trip and get like your recommendations. I'll leave them in the comments as well, because I'll check this video next time I go to Trader Joe's, which might be sooner than later, because our Trader Joe's is like really freaking nice today. I don't know why, it's just like decorated all cute. But anyway, I'm so sweaty and gross right now, but whatever. Here is the bag. And I actually have some other stuff. The other thing, I have to actually do this quickly because some of the stuff is frozen. I know I said I shouldn't get frozen stuff, but I did get a couple things, but no ice cream. That would be a donezo deal. But I'm really excited about some of the stuff that I got, and all the stuff only cost like $28. So I was super impressed. I think I've been shopping at Whole Foods too much because it's just closer, but oh my gosh, you don't walk out of there for less than like $40 or 60. Okay, so the first thing I got, milk chocolate covered peanut butter pretzels. This sounds amazing. I think these are frozen. Are they supposed to be frozen? I have no idea. Oh, just a cool place. But these were like above the freezer. I had a hard time finding these. I had seen these in a couple articles. Well, not these ones exactly, but like chocolate covered stuff. And they were always like right above the freezer, which maybe to prevent them from melting. I thought these look so good. I would have gotten the dark chocolate because I feel like that might be healthier, but I don't like dark chocolate. So we got the milk chocolate. We're not going to deprive ourselves of something just to make it a little bit better. We're going to get a full goodness in the bag. Two cauliflower gnocchis. I'm definitely gonna eat this bag probably today or tomorrow, and then I'll save this guy for a rainy day. I think these are so delicious. I did make these on my own. I don't think I filmed it. I think I put it on my Instagram story if you guys saw that, but they actually turned out really good, but it was so much work, honestly. So definitely these are much more worth it than hand making them, in my opinion, if you want cauliflower gnocchi. Oh, so good. Limes. I wanted to make some fresh squeezed like cocktails this weekend. Really like tasty but healthy. I mean, as healthy as you can get. Almost more natural, I guess you would say. Cocktails. So I like to get stuff that you can fresh squeeze. So limes. I thought I was going crazy. I walked around Whole Foods so many times. I thought they were probably going to kick me out because I thought I was trying to steal something, but I could not find oranges. Does Whole Foods just not sell oranges? Are they just not in season? Because I know Ralph sells oranges all the time. Maybe it's because they're like GMO'd or something. I don't know. Like they grow all year round. I don't know the seasons of oranges, but I had none. They had like little mandarins, but I can't squeeze them. Like I could squeeze them, but I need like 5 mandarins to juice enough that it would taste like something in a drink if you're making like an orange cocktail or something. So I didn't want those. But then finally I saw something that looked like a grapefruit. Turns out they are an orange. Cara Cara oranges. I don't know if these are like special Trader Joe's or what, or if it's just what they had there. But it had like a little like sign, like they write on it or whatever, and I kind of talked about it and basically just said they're kind of like blood oranges, which I think are really good. So I got those. Nice big bag. Okay, this guy is a total impulse buy and I'm so, so excited about it. Pastry puffs. Oh, I thought they were pastry puffs at first. Puffs is so much cuter, but they're just like these little, and they feel squished. They feel really squished. They're uncured mini beef franks wrapped in a puff pastry sprinkled with Parmesan cheese. Like the ultimate pigs in a blanket. Keep frozen. Well, not really. Sort of frozen. But these just look so good. I'm obsessed with pigs in a blanket, and these are already made, so I thought why not. They were nice and slim too. Like I know it's the weirdest things about stuff because of the fact that I have to carry everything on my back and in like a bag a long way home. Nice and slim, so they were a go. Finally, I got gluten-free pumpkin pancake mix. I do try to eat predominantly gluten-free stuff just because gluten sometimes upsets my stomach, but I will make an exception if I want something kind of like, you know, kind of like this, or like the pretzels as treats and everything, but I do try to eat pretty gluten-free. It just seemed like such a cool, splurgy, like breakfast thing. And the fact that it's already like pumpkin flavored, I know that's not even that much. It's just they put like pumpkin spice in there or something, but still, I thought that would be a really nice breakfast thing sometime, like on the weekend. Then I went to the place next door, which had nothing of what I needed. Oh yeah, I didn't tell you that best part is that this whole trip was supposed to be getting some stuff that I needed for a video. Well, when I went to the store next to it, they had none of the stuff I needed. None. Don't worry, I still ended up being able to spend quite a bit of money on this. I mean, $28 is not that bad for Trader Joe's, but then these next two things were a little bit more expensive, but it's fine, it's fine. The last two items that I got were for the cocktails. This Svedka Pure Infusion Strawberry Guava. I've never had this before. I love strawberry, and guava is like a really good taste too. And it has zero sugar, natural flavors, so it's not like a syrupy, like some flavored vodkas that you get are very sweet and they have added sugar, which I don't really like because I'm gonna add my own sugar and it's just like extra sugar you don't need. So I like them when they're zero sugar and I can add my own. So I'm really excited to try this. And I got just a truly tropical mix pack. Heavy, heavy. The interesting part, actually a little mini update or whatever. Remember I said that I was allergic to seltzers? I really thought I was. It's such a correlation. Every time I drank a seltzer, I would break out and I would itch and I would get all these red lines on me. And so I'm like, oh, Yeah, I'm allergic, I'm sneezing, all this stuff. Well, ever since I started this new diet, which I will go into another video, I haven't had a lot of that. I've definitely still had some allergy symptoms, but it's not really correlated to any type of food, any type of drink, and I've been able to have like a seltzer here and there without having any issues. So I really do think it was part of like the inflammation thing that I was talking about. So that's why I'm back on some seltzers. I'm not overdoing it, but just a couple every once in a while. That is my haul. And you know what? I wanna try this with you guys really quick. This is the Fed Cup here infusion. Can I do this on camera? Yeah. People are doing truth or drink. It's totally fine to try this. Like, is this gonna get like rated like R? I don't even know what you rate it up on YouTube, but ooh, that's really good. It's definitely less sweet for sure than a lot of flavored vodkas. So you kind of get the essence, but I do taste like a tiny bit of sweetness. Not a lot though. So I think maybe zero sugar might mean like zero added sugar, which is still perfectly fine. Like I just don't want the syrupy stuff in it. It does taste a little sweet. So there's probably maybe a little bit in there naturally, but it is very, very good. I don't know if I would drink this straight because you still have a lot of that vodka taste, but it's going to be delicious with a Truly mixed in there. That's why I got them, because I kept seeing like recipes online and it looked really easy. That is my Trader Joe's haul. Welcome back. Hey guys. It's a few days later. This is gonna be a mishmash of a vlog, but I have a ton of stuff to show you guys for hauls because I ended up getting like a whole bunch of stuff. We'll get into my next hauls in a second, but I'm using one of the things from the hauls, so I thought it'd be kind of cool to show you. I'm getting ready to take a picture for a campaign that I'm doing. So this is the double ceramic Conair Deep Waves. So I literally had one of these guys from way back in the day, and I just got rid of it maybe last year. I've never used this, I'm never gonna use it, and now it's coming back in style. I've been watching this one YouTuber, and she always does her hair like this, so now I want to do my hair like this. I don't know if it's gonna look good because it's just like the almost like a crimping kind of. I have good luck with Conair stuff though. I think this is like $26, $27, I forget. Looks exactly like the other one I had, only it's prettier because it's like this rose gold kind of color. Seems easy enough. What is this? Oh, I guess this is like heat settings. There's like heat settings around here, and then a turbo on and off. What does turbo do? And then just a power on and off. What heat setting should I do? I have thick hair, but I'm also scared of using it at like top speed or top whatever. Yeah, 18. Turbo heat up to 27 degrees burst. Oh, it's a burst of heat. Or difficult to style spots. I must not have that. I've never had one specific part of my hair that wouldn't curl more than the others. I really don't know what that means. Do you guys have the idea of one spot that you would need extra heat on? I feel like I'm missing something. Aha. Turned it on, it's blinking now. But I think I just kind of like clamp, 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 right? I think that's how you do it. Some experience is necessary when learning to use this styler. Cool. Good thing I decided to use it right before I need to take a picture that has to go up because it's part of a sponsorship. Wish me luck. I guess that means it's like keyed it up. It stopped blinking, so. 2-inch section, and I hold it down for like 5 seconds. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Another one. I think it's not doing anything. 2, 3, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Okay, that was double time. 1, 2, 3. I'll count my hands. I feel like it might need to be hotter. I think that might be the issue here. I don't know if this is the look for me. I feel a little flapper girl slash slept in a ponytail. All right, we'll go 20. I don't know. I feel like by doing the same piece over again, I'm gonna just make my hair look frizzy. Let's try this side. I mean, I don't know what I was expecting. It definitely looks like it's just clamping on my hair right here. It's really sad when you see something that works for someone else and you try it on yourself and it's just like, this wasn't meant for you. I wanted beachiness. Her hair always looks beachy. Maybe I'm starting too high up here. I think hers actually start here. I'm actually not hating it. You know what this is giving me a vibe from? If you guys ever saw Lucy in the Love Island, I forget what season it was, but she had like hair like this and I just thought it was so cute. It looks so surfer girlish. I feel like it's giving me that vibe a little bit. I would just need to obviously finish. You don't have to wait for me, but I'm going to just go through some more of these. Okay, this is what we have. I would say like 60% effort, but I just figured I wanted a little bit of texture to my hair for the picture, and I feel like it looks good. Definitely would change a couple things about what I've done, but honestly, like, it's not as bad as I thought it was gonna be. It actually is kind of a look. It definitely gives my hair a lot of volume. My hair is usually so freaking flat, but this is definitely giving me some, like, I don't know, it's just, to me, it reminds me of like a beachy thing. Maybe it's because the girl that I saw this on is like blonde and she was a surfer, but I don't know. I feel like I kind of like it. I need to work on my technique, but it's not bad. Got a little defined, but kind of like it.
All right, so this lighting's awful, but that's fine. I wanted to pop in and show you a couple things that I bought. One, because I really want to show you guys. I've been holding on to it because I want to show you, but then also I need to put it away, and I can't put it away until I show you guys part two of the hauls. I think my first part was like Trader Joe's, possibly the hair curler thing. There's a couple other things that I got too. I did a couple Amazon things. I need to cut down on that, but I keep remembering stuff that I need, and then I forget to put it in one order. But this is more the fun stuff that I'm going to show you. If you follow me on Instagram, you guys know I was like over the freaking moon about this black body contrast that I got from Amazon, because I have such a hard time picking out stuff like that. There's like a million of them, and they all have like okay reviews and then bad reviews, so you're like, I don't know what to do. I had purchased this one and I am in love, so I got two more colors. Mine in a size medium, which I'm really glad that I do, because if it was a small, I definitely think they would be too tight and just show a little much. So just the normal like body con, got it in red. I'm just all red today, but the material is almost like, I don't want to say a swimsuit material, but similar, but then the inside is almost like a really thin fleece lining, so it's very soft, but the outside's more of a sleek kind of swimsuit material. By the way, I just put out a jean haul. If you haven't seen that, I tried on a bunch of crazy jeans, but anyway, I have to push this up because it would be really freaking long if I didn't, but it doesn't look weird pushed up. Like, it's crazy how good it looks. I'm just over the moon. Super stretchy. Ugh. And I got it in blue. My favorite thing to do with these, because I have like a lower stomach that I'm not in love with, but I like to put like a plaid wrap around, just like tie it at my waist, and then it completely hides like my lower stomach. So it's just so much more comfortable. I can eat and I don't have to worry about looking bloated or anything like that. That's why I absolutely love the combination of this and that. The other thing I got from Amazon, which is kind of messed up right now. I don't know where anything went in here, but I don't know what this is. This is just like a little like metal throwing dart. I don't know. Hair cutting sheet. I guess I can switch up the color if I want them to be girl scissors. Maybe if you're cutting kids' hairs or something. The other thing I got was an outfit that I've been eyeing up for freaking ever. Like, it's gotta have been a couple years now. Finally pulled the trigger and got it. Lemon two-piece. You guys know I'm obsessed with lemons. So the minute I saw this, I knew it had to be mine. But I wasn't sure about sizes. Basically, this is the bottom, which, oh my gosh, it is so stretchy. That's what I was excited about, because my hips, my butt, if it's an outfit without stretch, like a bottom, I have to go up to like sometimes the large, and then the length gets too bad. But I got this in a small, and the length is absolutely perfect. It fits amazing around my stomach. Oh, it's so, so comfortable. The problem is the top. So when I first saw the top, I did have a little bit of a fear. I guess I hold weight in my arms as well. Like, I definitely like always focus on my legs and stomach, but my arms are never really like super, super skinny. So when there's something that goes around your arms, like little cuffing or something, it's usually tight around them. So that's where this kind of made me a little nervous. Obviously the bottoms fit great. If I had gotten a medium in the bottoms, they would have fallen right off. So I'm really glad I didn't size up in a medium for that. But the top around the sleeves, so you can see it just goes around here, like it's like a bandeau, I guess you kind of call it, but then it has the sleeves attached. These are tight, so they're not super uncomfortable tight, but I don't like the look of like squeezed in there, and that's what these are giving me. So I actually contemplated cutting these off and taking the fabric and just putting like a strap and making it, you know, like a spaghetti strap kind of thing, because the front is mad cute too. It has this little tie right here so you can cinch it. Actually, the sleeves are kind of cute because they also have ties, but it's just the fact that this will never fit me probably. I think in my skinniest, when I weigh 90 pounds, this probably would still be tight on me just because that's how my arms are. So I'm not sure what I'm gonna do yet. I don't know, but it's so cute. This one, I need to put in a video. This is the absolute holy grail of anything. Every person in the world who wears clothes should get this, I feel like. It's a really big sweeping statement, but it is the most amazing secret I've ever heard in my life for keeping stuff in place, all that kind of thing. Hands down, get this tattooed. Like, it's, you need this. This is toupee tape, which if you guys don't know what a toupee is, it's like a piece of hair that you attach to your head if you have hair loss. It basically just sticks where the hair is and it gives the illusion that you have like a full head of hair. To keep that on, I guess you use tape. I had never known this. This is actually, I heard the secret from Adrienne Bailon, I think I just pronounced her name. She had said about like fashion tape, because fashion tape has never worked for me ever. If you were trying to keep an outfit in place or something, fashion tape would always rip on me. Use toupee tape. It will not go anywhere. It is so, so sticky. I don't even know how it does it. It's just amazing. I mean, it makes sense because you don't want your hair to fall out of place, so that's probably gonna be very sticky, but I don't know why they don't make fashion tape this sticky. Get this. I swear to you, you need this. Last two things, and then I have to work out. Is the Marc Anthony's Volume Full Bloom Invisible Dry Shampoo. So I needed a dry shampoo, and this one kind of caught my eye. It looks cool, right? Kind of cartoony. It says no white residue. Also, the volume aspect. This is going on right now. Like, I got a lot of volume down here, if you want to call it volume. But my hair is always just so flat, so I wanted to see if this would work. I've used it a couple times so far. I'm not wearing it right now, and it's definitely done a really good job. This is from Shop Exo Clothing, I think they're called. They're joggers. They're so cute. If you watched my Fashion Nova jean haul, they're a little similar, but these ones are actually much more fitted, which is great because then I can wear them when I'm not going for like a super loose look. I love the little detailing. So excited that they fit because I wasn't sure, again, small or medium. The model that they use to model these clothing, she is so freaking cute. Tristan, I just love seeing her in all the clothes. She makes them all look so freaking good, which is bad for my bank, but she's very tiny, so I wasn't sure. She wears the small. I may be tiny, but I'm not tiny. These actually fit so good, and I'm obsessed. I love these with all of my heart. They have like a little thing at the bottom, but yeah. All right, I have to work out now. It's Thursday. We're almost done with the week. Hey guys, as I was editing the vlog that you're watching right now, I realized I never ended it. Sorry, the days got kind of crazy, but I just wanted to come on here and end this. I'm about to work out. Sans earrings and stuff. I have to remove all this. I just filmed a really fun video, but I just wanted to come on here and end the vlog. And also tomorrow we're filming a really, really exciting vlog as well. I'm so excited. It's my first time doing like a socially distanced, I guess like it's a Zoom thing, socially distanced product launch with a makeup brand. It's gonna be with The Balm, and I'm really excited. It's like a bunch of influencers together, and we're doing like a big Zoom call. We're making cocktails. It's kind of crazy. Like, I'm really excited, but I'm gonna take you guys all on that with me tomorrow. But right now I gotta work out. Hope you enjoyed this haul vlog. There was some stuff I wasn't able to get to, like a jewelry haul that I'll just put into either the next vlog or the next one. This video is getting too long, so thank you guys so much for watching. I will see you in my next one. Bye.